Hi, I'm Kimberly, and this is my book report. The book is titled The Boy Who Dared, by Susan Campbell Bernaletti. This is a story about a young man, who lived in Nazi Germany during the time of Hitler. At this time, there were laws against listening to foreign broadcasts on the radio. And this young man decided to go ahead and listen to foreign broadcasts, from England, which was a foreign country. And not only that, he wrote down what he heard about the war, which was very different from what his government told him was happening. And he made copies and he and his friends distributed them around the city he lived in, which was Hamburg, in Germany. What happened was that the police found out what he was doing. And they arrested him. And then they held a trial and found him guilty and executed him. So first of all, there are reasons why governments have national secrets. We entrust our government to protect us, and in so doing, it must decide what information to make public and what information to keep secret. After all, if our enemies know in advance about our troop movements, then we will be defeated and our men in uniform will die needlessly. This is what we need to remember. We also need to remember that this young man was living in a democracy. So these laws that he disagreed with about listening to foreign radio broadcasts, and torturing people who criticize the government, and that kind of thing. Well, these were all laws put in place by his elected leaders. So he really has no grounds for opposing them. I mean, these were the people he... Well, okay, not him directly, but his parents and everyone else, elected to represent him. So he needs to respect that and respect the outcome of that process. This is a democracy, and in a democracy, not everyone is happy with every decision all of the time, but if we all just disrespect the laws we don't like, then we'll have anarchy and chaos. It may not be a perfect system, but it's the best one we have, and so we need to respect it. And respect the leaders who we elect to be our representatives. So honestly, I don't know what this boy was expecting when he decided to break the law and go against direct orders not to listen to shortwave radios, where one might hear enemy propaganda. Also, remember this is wartime. And when a nation is at war, we must all stand together. We must put our differences aside and support our leaders, whether we agree with them or not. Otherwise, the enemy wins. I understand that some people might feel sympathy for this boy because he was only 17 years old, but let me tell you something. I am almost 17 myself, and I'm old enough to know the difference between right and wrong. I know that breaking the law is wrong, and I know to expect punishment for my wrongdoings. So, for those of you who are feeling sorry for this young man, I will say this: if he didn't want to end up the way he did, all he had to do was to follow the law. It's not that hard. Sorry, but the truth can be harsh sometimes. In closing, I have to say that I feel it is truly irresponsible for the author to portray this young man as some kind of hero. What kind of example does this set for our young people? Because if young people will betray the Nazi government, they'll betray any government.